Mississippi and New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden lead. This team is off the hook and you don't really want none. But if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Philadelphia Eagles. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first. Now that last run good enough to have him surpass for his career, get this folks, 12,000 rushing yards.
And how about this, you're in shouting distance now of the top 10 all-time rushers in NFL history. And in short order now, you've got Thurman Thomas, Franco Harris, Marcus Allen, and Edgerrin James right ahead of you. He can zoom past them with just a few more carries.
They're going to look to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Hunter. 7 yards there and a first down. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. They'll run it now out of the gun. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now back to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. Here we go. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 25-yard line. They'll look to throw here on first down. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this down to about the 17. Now we're going to get a timeout. Here's we've got an injured Buccaneer. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Looking to throw. Yeah, he's got it. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Every coach we ever talk to says to his team before the game, quick start, guys. Let's get out of the gate fast. How about that? They took his lesson to heart, didn't they?
They did exactly that. A nice diving catch here on the game's opening drive. They'll run here with Connor. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That really sets them back. A loss of 6. It's second and goal. Back to the 8-yard line now. Here's 2nd and 8. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. So 2 plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's 3rd and 16. They'll look to throw here. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Jackson on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A big pickup of 38. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Eagle passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down.
Brent, I think we can see early on they're making a concerted effort to get him the football. So to me, that means they like the matchup that they have. They feel like he's better than the guys that are covering him.
2 plays, 2 passes. We'll see if they go back to that well. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7. Now it's Jackson. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. From 13 yards out, as his guys can now take the lead with the extra point. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. But I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's
right. That's the highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He goes full extension, and he's got it. Call that a very strong gain of 24. So 1 play, and they're already just shy of midfield. They'll run it now out of the gun. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. Here's a 2nd and 7. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And a big gain that time. He's out of bounds on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1, a 1-point game, 7-6. First down, he'll drop to throw. Throw left side, complete. That's Hunter. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for 2nd down, staying ahead of schedule. 2nd and 2. Going to go down back at the 27-yard line. He's sacked.
And that's their first sack of this game. But how about last week? 6 sacks. Great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. Now for the field goal try, here's Eddie Pinheiro. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. And the 13-year man puts it through, and they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So that's a seven-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front seven? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. On second and 10. Jackson, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Here's Jackson on third and long. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he takes it all the way down to the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. From the gun, Jackson. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. From 3 yards out, and once again, the Eagles are back out in front. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is up to 5. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 34-yard line. This quarterback now 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys a first and 10. This is Connor running right. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 21. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. His throw caught right around the 6. Let's go, baby. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. From 3 yards out, and the Buccaneers have once again taken the lead. This time, the extra point up and good, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you...
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. A really nice gain of 25 yards. They'll look to throw now on first down. Throwing right, and that's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. Back to throw here. And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And that will push the lead up to 5. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get 3 before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now we're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. Jackson now, 7 of 10 here in this first half, and he's got a 1st and 10. Now Jackson, he's going to float this over the middle, deep. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've come to halftime in a 5-point game. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get... And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Well, that's 3 picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season... Because here we are in December, right? It is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
And the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Here's 2nd and 10 now from about the 32. Second and 10. throwing the out route and complete. It's Hunter. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. A little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Back at the two now. Here's second and goal. Touchdown grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia. A big play there. His third touchdown now on the year, as his guys are back within a single score. The PAT good. It would draw him closer, but hold on just a second. A flag is down on the field, so they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
A five-point game now as here comes the kickoff. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. He'll look to throw. He completes it to Hunter. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab as the Buccaneers tack onto their lead. That's an early touchdown grab for last week's NFC Offensive Player of the Week. He was so electric, and they talked about it all week long. Have to try to contain him.
And now for him, being able to focus on the task at hand and not just immediately assume that last week totally carries over, but you got to like the start that he has, showing those great hands that we've seen from him throughout.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. Maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
From the gun, it's Jackson. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 45-yard line. 17 yards and a first down for Philly. Jackson now 9 of 15 throwing the ball, 60%, and it's first and 10. Jackson from the shotgun, eluding the pressure right. Throwing right, and that's complete. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well. They'll get a few stops.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. From the 16, Jackson. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They have certainly looked his way in this third quarter. Another catch, and it's good for a first down. Escaping the pressure right. He'll run it. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. Here's Jackson. Flushed out right. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Jackson, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. A 2-yard touchdown grab as his guys are back within a single score.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's 2 touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone looked at a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And the return will stop right around the 25. Well, this D, particularly the secondary, has been picked apart at points here tonight. They finally, though, get to the quarterback, get a pick.
And we know this about him. He loves night games, loves the spotlight, loves being the center of attention. I will bet you that he ran off the field almost chuckling to himself. They finally got one. They finally got me.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. From 19 yards away as his guys are able to regain the lead.
There it is, partner. You see it. Four fingers. What does that mean?
Four fingers. That signifies the fourth quarter's here.
That's right. Who's going to dominate? Usually both teams are holding them up. We own the fourth quarter, what we found out so far. Two touchdowns here, and now they've taken the lead.
Yeah, second one putting them in front. You know what I see on the other sideline, though? It seems like they've tensed up, had that lead. They were playing not to lose it, and they've lost it.
That's a great observation. When you play not to lose, you usually don't win.
Now, though, they'll have the opportunity to respond. So that effort gives them a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about, not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
This is taken at his four. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. It's a big play there for the Buccaneers. 54 yards. Back to throw now on first down. Looking for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. They're going to look to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And not much on the return there. He'll take it only up to the 9-yard line. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 2. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Now it's Jackson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Watch the curve. The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Critical play in this football game because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Flush to his Jackson hit, and he lost the football. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing now, Jackson on first down.
Now he'll pull it down. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's 2nd and 1.
Mike, check. 59.
Now Jackson. Forced out to his left. And he's going to keep it here. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Now it's Jackson. And he's caught right at the 10-yard line. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. Jackson now. And it's caught at the 7-yard line. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. 7 yards the pickup on the pitch and catch. To throw again on 2nd down. Jackson. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. From 3 yards out. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. Extra point right down the middle. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, 2-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
2nd and 5. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 49, and they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Good starting field position for them as they come up 1st and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. Despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on 1st down, but he couldn't reel it in. So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. 10. Throwing now is Jackson. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Now the Eagles will use the 2nd of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. They wound up getting nothing out of that 2nd down completion, so now here's 3rd and 10. Here's Jackson. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 24. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. The Eagles will take their 3rd and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door and maybe get back to big.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. And whistles, and they take their final timeout with 7 seconds left. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Second and long. Throwing middle, and it's complete. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Philadelphia, the streak lives as they move to 13-0 now on the year. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Bucs, it's their very first clunker of the year as they'll fall to 12-1. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. We're just about set to get started, and this ought to be a good one between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the New Orleans Saints. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, it is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the New Orleans Saints. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
It's the final three to play for here as we're underway in week 15. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. On first down, Dillon. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. And they'll try the jet sweep here. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
17 there in a New Orleans first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
On second down, Mathis. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. The numbers for him from a week ago, 18 carries, 63 yards. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
I can't remember the last time we did a game, and a coach didn't talk about establishing the run first, but they've lost two straight games, so they still want to do that, but they've got to have
nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
How about that? Well, the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Over the middle, complete. That's Ballard. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. They'll look to throw. Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end or wide receiver, that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand that without a quarterback, they don't make the plays that they make.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5, and the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. Throwing on first down, Dillon. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down.
Not only they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely, great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about 4. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. yards. Second down now. Mathis, he's got a first down and more inside the 30. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good.
And got his man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
He'll look to throw. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. From 8 yards out, as they are now on the board here in the first half.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. So, Charles, the season winding down, the playoffs obviously not in their futures. They look ahead to the offseason. What spots do they maybe need to fill?
I think that they like the guy who's calling the plays and throwing the ball. I think that he's a pretty good player. Needs some help, I think, on the perimeter, though. Help him out with receivers, because I think if he gets an upgrade there, his play gets out much better, too.
Here we go on second and 12. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you, because it seems to be working pretty well.
And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Dillon. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And down inside the 15 he goes.
Down. 50, plant.
59, Mike, the 59. Go, tackle, let's go. We got this, we got this.
Fire.
They'll run on first down. Mathis. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Second and 11. That's complete to Whitaker. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Saints have taken the lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. A drive that time of six plays. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the... The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
It's a gain of 23 yards. First down, Buccaneers.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Dexter Lawrence in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 28. He'll look to throw, and he's got it. Caught in the end zone, touchdown, Tampa Bay. As his guys are in for six, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides of this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a... Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
That's three sacks now. That's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team... they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again. Looking to throw. Dillon. It's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And he's got his man on the out route. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Here comes the Saints punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is taken at the 18. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Just over 30 seconds to go in the half. They've got it first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to fight. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. So we've... and now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan showing you.
A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 42 yards. Well, make that now. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. From 3 yards out, as his guys are able to regain the lead. The touchdown all set up by the big play one snap before, but they finish it off here with a shorter completion, this time for the score.
I like how they stuck with what got them there, right? The big pass play. Got the momentum going, right? That's, you create it with a play like that, and you come right back with another pass play to finalize things off.
The extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 21-14. So they only needed three plays on that drive, and it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point, but it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Check 31, check it.
On first down, Mathis takes it to the 26, just a one-yard gain.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll keep it on the ground. Mathis, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
To throw on third down. Dillon, nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency. Taking care of the ball, making sure it gets to the right people, no errors, right? Not turning it over, and just doing all the right things. That's leadership, and it inspires confidence in a team.
Yeah, been a good leadership and a good distributor. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and three. He completes it to Hunter. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Looking to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
The throw right sideline here is complete. That throw good for 4. It's second down. They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24. 2nd and 6. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
A terrific return there, 27 yards all told. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Let's go.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Back to throw. This is caught. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. In for the score. As the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Going up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone. That's what it's all about.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive. You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Here's a run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Looking to throw on second down. Dillon, nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Remember, throughout my career here, defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little trigger.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged.
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. 23 yards for the touchdown as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And that touchdown reception is the fifth for him in this game, and that ties the NFL record.
And a record that's held up since 1950. This is another person that's tied it, but think about this. Bob Shaw said it in 1950. Kellen Winslow came along and tied it. And then, of course, Jerry Rice tied it as well. And finally, we're seeing it here one more time. Phenomenal.
Out comes the Saints offensive unit and the NFC playoff race. Let's have a look at it. And it's right about this time of year you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
And I think for most teams, the obvious is to try and be the number one or number two seed. But when you look at it across the league and in throughout the history of trying to get to the Super Bowl, the teams you really fear are the ones that get hot and sometimes sneak in at a 5 or a 6 seed, because we've seen those teams actually get to the Super Bowl and occasionally win it.
Yeah, you think of the Giants a couple of times. Steelers have done it. You're right. It has happened and will happen more in the future, I'm sure. From the gun, Dillon. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones maybe.
It's a foot race. The 20, 10, touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. With his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
This is taken at the 3. Fights loose. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And the Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. Well, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
A well-executed 22-yard gain. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. It's a gain of 16, first down tip, and he pulls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And that, boys and girls, is an NFL record. 6th touchdown reception. The record has stood since 1950. What a game.
How about that? Because so many things have to go right in order for it to happen. Not just him catching the passes. Someone delivering it accurately. Offensive line giving them time to throw the ball. A true team record. But he stands above it because he was on the receiving end of so many great plays.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. He'll have a first down past the 40. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A big play there. 72 yards. And the Saints get a bit closer. No problem there on the extra point. And the lead will be cut down to 14. 2 scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Here we go. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got it 1st and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided.
Back to throw here. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So now he's equaled his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going
to
pick.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Hey, let's go.
The Saints in a hurry up here. Clock continuing to roll. Off play action. Dillon, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
Set. 18, Gator.
Back to 59.
Let's go, defense. Our time. It's
our Griff.
Operating from the gun. Dillon. And he's going to be taken down. Sacked back at the two. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans. Number two. As they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. On fourth down, Dillon. Under pressure and down he goes in the end zone, and that's a safety. So that a double whammy. Not only do you have to give away the football, but the 2 points mean this is now a two-score game.
And two doesn't seem like much, does it? But it means everything in this situation, because now they're going to have to look back, and ultimately that might be the play that ends up deciding this game.
Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Ballard. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. They'll back to throw. That's going to be caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. They're going to look to throw. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A one-yard touchdown reception as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. So they go with a pass, and it works there on the two-point try. Charles, just in general, what are your thoughts, passing versus running on two-point conversion? Situational?
It is situational, and you have to know your team. What is your strength? Because so many people think you have to throw the ball on a two-point conversion, but the stats will tell you that running it is about as proficient. So know your team and go to your strength.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And last time they surrendered to safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the...
Accelerating, and off he goes. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go! Let's go!
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. They drop to throw. Wide open receiver complete. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So they'll come up first and 10 now from... They'll look to throw here. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off inside the 10. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Tampa Bay, they continue to make their case as a Super Bowl favorite as they move to 13-1. And they'll have another road day next week with the Los Angeles Rams. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they drop their 10th game now to fall to 4-10. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Hello, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports.
From the second largest city in the U.S., Los Angeles, California, we've got football as EA Sports coverage of the NFL is on the air. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Los Angeles Rams. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. From the 32 now. Here's first and 10.
Right, right, right. He's tight on you. He's tight on the right. Tight on the right. Four down. Four down.
Now back to throw. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point, get your head around, locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this.
Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off at the 28, and they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
A three-yard loss. Fourth down now.
A quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially given 15. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. They'll look to throw now on first down. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They'll set up the throw. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Well, there definitely was some juice. On that pass, and while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
On first and 10, Beyer, nowhere to go here. He lost the football, but fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
Well, that was a big oops right there, but how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, bounced right back on it, keeps possession. Now a nice throw here, right side, he hauls it in. He's got daylight, past the 20, touchdown LA! A big play there, 79 yards. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
That one goes for 24 yards. They'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And it's caught. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. He'll look to throw. And he is the NFC reigning offensive player of the week. You got to think, all the guys that take the field each and every week, that's not an easy award. Always has to feel good to grab.
It has to feel great because it separates you, at least for a week, amongst your peers. And for him to separate again, he has had the same time.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read, and it's picked off. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
On first down, Bear looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Person. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. A gain of 6 there on first. On second down, Elam. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 2, now third down. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Off the play fake, Beyer. And Wilson has it. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A good pickup, 17 yards, and also a Rams first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And again, this time to the tailback. To the 40 and no further. The razzle-dazzle, though, got him a couple extra on the play. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there. Here we go,
switch it. On second down now, Elam. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. They lost two there, and it's third down.
70, Indy. Mike 59.
Back to throw. Bear under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Coming off the line, he's been wreaking havoc all year. And look, that's why, as a result, he's getting some looks for Defensive Player of the Year in the NFL.
And I know that many people don't have him first on their list right now, but he deserves that type of consideration. You mentioned it. All year long, he's made big plays and continues to do so. Imagine if he has a big game here. If so.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And he just won.
Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A big play there. 47 yards as they are now on the board here in the first half.
Brandon, they just got the ball, and already they're in the end zone, and you're getting ready to talk about the PAT. That was fast.
The extra point up and good, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. On first down, Elam trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, they have the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. The Rams on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Looking to throw. Beyer. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Well, that's a perfect example of how he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's game. He is just all around the football right now, isn't he?
That he is, and it's funny because I talked with the coaching staff about drills that they do in practice, and one of them is called matching hands. And as soon as that hand is launched by the quarterback, you throw up the opposite hand and match that hand with the QB, and oftentimes you're able to knock it away, as we just saw there.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Going to throw right side here. Complete. First play of the drive, a success. 19 yards. This quarterback now over 200 yards already in this first half. It's 1st and 10. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. 2nd down. So 2nd down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. We've hit the 2-minute mark in the first half. All knotted up, it's 7. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Bucs have taken the lead.
Well, the lost sleep that the defensive coordinator had all week preparing for this game, a good portion of it was trying to prepare for him, because he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a lot of times around the goal line, they know it's going to him. It's just so hard to stop.
And that's where it really becomes difficult, because you're exactly right. They know it's going to him, yet they still can't stop it. That tells you when you're a dominant player.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's had a good chunk of carries. Problem is, for very little success. I don't want to put it all on his shoulders, but that's a big reason they're losing right now.
Have to be very careful that he doesn't start pointing fingers. Offensive line obviously trying. The defense is doing a nice job against him today. When it's all said and done, it's all about the guy in the mirror. He has to get it done better going
forward. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Three down.
Back to throw. Bear firing quickly here, and that's complete. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Looking to throw. Beyer. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. He's looking for another four-sack gain. That's how many he had last week. That's his third.
And when I watch him rush the passer, the thing that always comes to mind for me is how well he uses his hands. The martial arts stuff that a lot of guys do in the offseason to work on those, paying dividends for him. He's getting home in a big way.
This is taken at about the 14. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two.
Coming to you. Hey, check Mike.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Going up top. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Second and 10. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Well, free safety blitz, that can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass.
It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. So we have reached half, and just like that, on we head to half number two. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
They'll keep it on the ground. Elam, only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Able to locate Wilson. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. A huge play that time for the Rams. 48 yards. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Back to throw. Bear. Rush coming, and he he's taken down. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed the hole. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. As his guys are in for six. As they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Sanders now to add the extra point. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. Five plays there on that drive. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded at the two. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Ballard. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 17 yards on the play and a Buccaneer first down. Looking to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. Touchdown, Tampa Bay!
Touchdown.
A big play there. 62 yards. As his guys are able to regain the lead. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. From the gun, Beyer over the middle, complete. It's Person. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. First down, Los Angeles there with a pickup of 14 yards. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Here comes the Rams punter now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 15. So possession goes over here on the punt. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Second and 5. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 27 yards there, a first down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. This will be caught inside the 10. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A 7-yard touchdown grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern in the middle of the end zone.
And ordinarily, that's a tough spot to find because there's usually coverage to take away that portion of the field. But they found a gap, and they exploited it.
So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. This fielded at the 2. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault.
He's going to be taken down. They sack him on what will be the final play of quarter number 3. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Rams on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be 3rd and 15.
Get it ready.
Looking to throw. Bear. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And it'll be 4th down.
Don't let him breathe. Don't get it.
On fourth down, Byer. And that is incomplete. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And now the football's going to go over, already being placed at the 15-yard line. But down two scores, I guess they felt like they needed to go for it. They must have thought they had a play to dial up that they could get it. Well, didn't work out.
They must have thought, as you pointed out, they had a play. And they were probably looking at the number.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Let's go, touchdown, baby.
A 15-yard touchdown grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead.
Well, after another passing touchdown, I don't think it'd be an understatement to say that he's in the zone. And I believe he likes it.
Point after, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Second and four. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8. This quarterback now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Second and 6. He's got it complete to Perkins. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. The Rams on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Back to throw. Bear. Yeah, quick throw here. That's complete. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat him on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
And then he goes with a juke. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. First down, Los Angeles there with a pickup of 14 yards. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Operating from the gun. Byer, throw left side, complete. That's Person. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. 2nd and 5 after the 5-yard completion on 1st down. Looking to throw. Bear, he's got it complete to Perkins. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Now defensively, you look at the numbers, another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback...
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. On fourth down, Byer. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Man, the most curious way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety.
All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it. But you know, every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction. And that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it cost him.
Focus, defense, focus.
They'll run on first down. Elam. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. That's taken in by the tight end Perkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. Back to throw. Bear. He completes it to Wilson. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. A good pickup, 17 yards, and also a Rams first down. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. Throwing on first down, Byer. This is caught, and he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. From 21 yards away, and the Rams are able to cut into this lead. He has his two scores, but still a sizable deficit in this game.
Do you have him in fantasy football this week?
Unfortunately, no.
It's too bad, right? That would have been big points. But he is really trying to rally his team as best he can. Things are not going as well the rest of the way for them. That's why they're down with this deficit. He might need to score a couple of more times to give them a chance.
So time definitely not in their favor. Down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things. Now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Watch the screen, watch the screen.
That one looks like he'll throw here. His throw caught right around the six. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. In for the score as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point safely through.
Well, I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want to, because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
On first and 10, Bear throwing right, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. On first down, Byer looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Person. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down LA. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Looking to throw. There. And that will be incomplete, as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and
the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Bucks, it's another win for them. And you wonder if they want a redo on that one loss as they sit now at 14-1. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for L.A., it's another loss as they now fall to 4-11. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. You're tuned in to Sunday Night Football on EA Sports. We are moments away from kickoff, and we've got a good one on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I'll join you again at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from earlier this afternoon. But for now, it's Sunday Night Football. And on the call, as always, Brandon Godfrey and Charles Davis.
And we're about 5 miles northwest of downtown Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here we go. The final week of the NFL season, week 17, is underway. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general.
What I enjoyed this week is that you asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is. And that was a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him. That's the thing. They really care. And when you care that much, you're going to play that much harder for him and give him a better chance to lead the team to wins.
Season as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
That is a quick strike, one play all the way to the house. You know, the pass was fine, but that run after the catch, impressive.
An absolute horrible time. Of course, any time like this is a horrible time for a defensive breakdown. But where's the tackling? Where were the safeties? You don't expect him to catch the ball, and next thing you know, he's running into the goalpost this early in the game. That's not supposed to happen.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Set up to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He completes it to Hunter. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. They'll set up a throw.
One thing we do know, he's
a battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
And now the drive starts with a completion out to the right. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. He got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Well, look at the Buccaneers starters now on defense. They were terrific last week in the win over the Rams. And last week in that victory, they were pretty good. Probably a pretty easy film session, I would imagine.
And after a performance like that, so many people think you just roll in the film, take your popcorn, kick back, and enjoy the show because they played well. I can just tell you from experience, after a win is when coaches come down on you harder, because they want to emphasize all the mistakes that happened. Because you won, you're in a good mood, they want to bring you back to earth. Oftentimes you walk out of there and you ask your teammate, did we win that?
Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A big play there. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14-0.
Yeah, and mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that, obviously your confidence rises in a big way, and you're putting some doubt in their minds.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Oh, he didn't spike it. He faked it. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. Second and nine now. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Easy to tell who they're targeting on this drive. He caught the first two passes, but then this time unable to hook up.
But I don't think that stops them from continuing to go back to him, do you?
No.
I mean, they've got a plan. They're trying to execute it.
And after that second catch, I saw him in the huddle. He said, hey, let's go back one more time. Didn't work there. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28. They'll drop the throw. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. 23 yards for the touchdown as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Good bounce back drive right there through the pick on drive number one. Drive number two leads him right down the field into the end zone.
Agree totally. Excellent bounce back, tremendous poise, confidence never lost, and obviously he transmitted that to his teammates as well. What a really nice drive.
This one fielded at the five. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And the magnitude of this game, everybody knows it. The fans, obviously, the players and coaches, there's just with them a palpable buzz right now. They know they control their own destiny.
Win and you're in. And I think every player wants that. I think every coach wants that. I haven't been in an organization yet that wants to be in a game where they have to rely on other teams to get them to their goals. In this situation, it's very cut and dry. Win and you're in the playoffs. That's their mission. That's their challenge. And you know they've chosen to accept it.
And what they told us is this has been the most focused week of practice we've had all year. You wouldn't expect any different.
Yeah, and you know, at the beginning of the season, you have multiple goals. They just have one now. Win the game.
They'll look to throw here. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Ready, great.
They're going to look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Stevens. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Pretty heavy traffic over the middle on that one, and somehow he emerged with the football. Way to possess it despite all the extra contact and people around him.
Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him as it is. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out.
And he is going to wind up losing yardage here, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. Panther football to start quarter number two, as they got it with a second down coming up. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
You've called plenty of games in your career. Do you believe in momentum, my man?
I do, and I think we're seeing it right here.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. The run that he's been on, how about that? Three sacks in a game a week ago, and another one right here. Oh, he's feeling it in a big way.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. He's good, and he holds it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. As his guys are in for six, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. A diving catch for the score he laid out. That was special.
And you know the first thing they're going to check, right? Did he complete the process of the catch? All the way through, all the way to the ground. Ball doesn't hit the ground without control in his hands. All of that, yes. Check the box, touchdown.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
On first down, Norris. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and six. They'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Norris. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially
if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. Give him a couple on the catch at second and eight. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. This quarterback now 10 of 10 to start the game. How about that? Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. From 19 yards away. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. That's one of those long drives where not only do you score, but you really tire out the defense too.
That's a great point, because now they've been on the field for a long time. Them going to the bench, trying to make adjustments, trying to figure things out, but they'll do so fatigued.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Second and 10 now from the 27. Second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. He'll look to throw. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards, the final tally. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Definitely worth taking another deep shot here. He's already found the end zone twice here in the first half.
Yeah, go back to that same well. They've had trouble containing him, but able to contain him on that play. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
You're trailing. You're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful, because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side. Rush coming, and he's taken down. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop him with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Looking to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Now back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. The Bucks forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Back to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. But hang on, a flag is down. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. Of course, they had the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
This one taken from the 7. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. And he's looking to take much better care of the football here in half two after 3 first half interceptions.
Well, not to just look strictly at the numbers here. You know what else happens to a team when you turn it over 3 times like that? It erodes confidence in you. And it erodes confidence in the offense. And now you have the defensive guys looking over and saying, what is going on here? And instead of playing for the team, they're playing angry and mad at their teammates.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Yeah, he's got it. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Back to throw here. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone, touchdown Tampa Bay. From a yard out, as his guys are back within a single score. And now Coach Bruce Arians has made the call. His guys will go for 2. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Well, I guess the coach looked at the 2-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a 3-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a 2-point conversion, and now they're only down 3 and feeling great about themselves.
The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3 except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
That second down play, that's a -4.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it's just a little inspirational speech. Who knows?
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
He's the NFL sack leader coming into the game, and now that's 2 more that he's added to his total.
He wants some separation from spot 1 and 2 in that sack category. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. This is fielded at the 27. 51 yards on the punt there. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. He'll drop to throw.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere. In the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. He'll look to throw. This offense, and they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Bucs have taken the lead. And he's such a talented tight end, just creates nightmarish tight matchups on the other side.
He's so good that when we say tight end, we're almost damning him with faint praise, aren't we? Because he can do it all. He's as good as any receiver in the NFL.
Well, that's the deal. He's a wide receiver, just in a bigger body.
Bigger body, a matchup nightmare, and who's going to cover him? When I sit in the film session, I just look at the coach and say, really? Really? You're going to yell at me? You go cover him.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Boy, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Hey, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
A throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. Extra point up and through. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. They have the short field and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. A solid first half for him, and so far a good start to the second half.
And I'm going to try not to go overboard with praise here, but I can't help it. He was playing
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And hear the pressure from the outside linebacking spot.
And normally when that happens and they're able to get home, that means other guys on his team helped him out a lot. But they occupied people to allow it to be no less than a one-on-one situation, allows him to get home.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. They'll look to set up his blockers. A very good return that time. 18 yards. So out come the Bucs now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before,
replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
And this is caught at the 8. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. The Bucs passing game looking good on this. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. From 6 yards away, as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead.
Brandon, is there any way you and I can join this quarterback in the zone he's in? He's absolutely feeling it. Touchdown after touchdown, throwing the ball.
Point after, right down the middle. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Panthers, they're able to draw a bit closer. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just one play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag. But you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
Pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field, and intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off inside the 5, and he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line.
Intercepted. Come on, guys. We got this.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a pick.
Piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust. This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Second and five. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again to the tune of seven sacks in this game thus far.
The Panthers on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third down and 12. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Come get some. Come on.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. And the Panthers turned away on fourth down. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Apparently they weren't interested in playing the field position game. They opt to keep their offense out there. A big mistake in hindsight.
Yeah, that one backfired, and hindsight's always 20-20. But
and he's got it! Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! A 14-yard touchdown as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. I don't even know what to say anymore. I mean, I've lost track of how many times he's been in the end zone. This is just flat unbelievable.
Doesn't matter whether you have an abacus, a calculator, just old-fashioned pencil and paper trying to total it up. The number is staggering. What a performance. This man knows how to find the end zone and make it count.
This one fielded at the 5. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. They'll set up to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. On third down, it's Norris. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That winds up being a 4-yard loss and leads to fourth down. This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak. Not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
And the Panthers turned away on fourth down, and it'll be a turnover on downs. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. This throw caught right around the 6. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. The Bucs passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. First So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. From 6 yards away as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to drop those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But if you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. They worked out for six.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, Carolina. A big play there. With his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. The Panther offense staying put. They'll go for two.
Let's go, D. Tighten up.
They'll look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. A big pickup there, 18 yards and a Buccaneer first. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll set up a throw. He completes it to Hunter. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Second and 11. This throw caught right around the 6. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. They'll drop the throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scramble. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Check that.
We got Mike 52 right here.
They're looking to throw here. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you?
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. From 4 yards out as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
The extra point up and good, and they open the lead up now to 25. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at the three. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And he fields it cleanly. A very good return there, giving it even 20 yards. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Ballard. Now we'll get whistles, and they signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Over the middle, complete. That's Ballard. Oh, wait, hold everything. A timeout has been called. Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They're going to look to throw. Letting one go deep. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Read it well, and it's picked. And that will write a finish to this ball game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Buccaneers, they'll wrap up the campaign an impressive 15-1. And now they'll have the week off as they get set to go after a Super Bowl title. Meanwhile...